absolutely right.
Can we just skip to the part?
Fasten tight.
You and you shut up.
You think me mad?
Mad? No. Insufferable? Surely.
What are you trying to hear anyway?
Here to register, sir. Good, good. Magister Williams is just about done with the last passenger. You faring okay so far? Trust me, with Bishop Alexander in charge, things will get a lot better from here on out. He's godwoken, you know. You head on in now. Williams will get you sorted fast.
Shut up.
Keep those bumps trying on her. And if she tries to run, shoot to kill.
You seem on edge, officer. What on earth is the matter?
Murder most foul. And I strongly suspect you know all about it.
Do you? Well, perhaps you're absolutely right.
Standing at the center of the room, you spot a sorcerer haughtily eyeing a pair of nervous-looking magisters. They keep their crossbow trained upon her as she's being interrogated by an officer.
So you admit it then? You murdered that poor fella?
Yes, I did. But of course, that was only the beginning.
She turns her head and looks you straight in the eye.
There are others whose lives must end.
Good God! The woman's mad! You there, sorcerer! Go and fetch Magister Siwan! We need to do more than collar this maniac. We need to shackle her hands and feet.
It means your journey draws to a close. Do stick around for its finale, though, because...
She reaches for her collar and simply removes it.
I'm just about to create a scene.
Subdue her, men, quickly! If she casts source, the Voidwoken will come. They'll end us all.
She smiles with wicked satisfaction.
Precisely.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Ifan lies motionless, curled on the ground like an animal. Under his shaggy hair, you can see green eyes fluttering as if in a nightmare. A low whine escapes his lips. His eyes flicker open, but he doesn't register your presence at all.
Lucian. Lucian.
Ifan cries out, then his eyes fall closed again. No matter how much you shake him now, he cannot be roused.
No, not the final dark. Not yet.
It's no use. Your words do not seem to reach her.
The dice roll darkly. They're rolling for me.
The dwarf lies in a heap on the floor, his great beard twisted and tangled around him. He is stock still. You can't see if he's living or dead. You hear a faint thud, thud, thud. He's alive, but only just. The young woman lies in a heap on the floor. She's breathing normally, but her eyes are wide open, like those of a corpse. Dark, greyish-black clouds swirl through them.
No.
The Magister lies on the floor, unconscious and bleeding from a dire-looking wound.
Is blocked. I'll need to find another way.
Upwards. By divine grace, what was...
He eyes the collar circling your neck and reaches a hand towards his blade.
Another sorcerer!
The Magister's companion doesn't blink, frozen in place at the sight of you.
Like you don't know. Mutiny! Did that witch fix your collar too?
He whispers loudly to the other Magister.
Don't just cower there, Rix. Take out your blade!
Rix grabs his sword, which shakes in the rhythm of his trembling hand.
Siran will have to wait. We're not going deeper below decks. Not now. Go then. Get out of here. Get on with you.
Just leave me be.
The hound paws desperately at its snout. It winces as it draws blood from its wet, black nose and continues scratching. The dog notices you for the first time and snarls, the hairs on its back prickling as it lowers itself into a lunge.
Sorcerer!
It sneezes suddenly and paws at its nose once more.
Can't smell! Can't breathe! Too much sauce! Too much! Too much! Please, make it stop! Too much. Too much. Can't smell. Can't breathe.
The dog whines and continues pawing at its nose.
Thank you.
to get off this wreck and quick! Pounding on the hull.
Pass through the door and are suddenly face to face with an undead. His skull is bizarrely angular, and a glorious jewel sits in the middle of his forehead. The skeleton is quickly leafing through a volume of Cranley Hubert's famous encyclopedia, muttering to himself.
No, no, no! What damn fools record knowledge on a pulped tree? It catches fire, it turns into must when wet, it cannot even resist acid! No wonder they're so bloody ignorant.
The skeleton looks up and notices you for the first time.
Oh, it's you. Shouldn't you be running and screaming or some such?
The skeleton groans and looks back to his book, frantically flipping from page to page.
Yes, indeed. It's the look of someone that wants to read the bloody book he's holding. Now, if you're really quite finished, I believe you have lifeboats to flee to. Please, I was no more an elf than you are those rags you're wearing. I had a mask, rather ingeniously designed, which allowed me to take that primitive form. A mask that was stolen by that damned witch after her little scene. Still, she'll drown with the rest of these fools, and I will simply pluck my mask from her cold, dead hands. Indeed, just as sensible as getting off a sinking ship and leaving a fellow to his business. I would say good day, but it seems quite likely that you're about to die a rather terrible death, so...
The skeleton shrugs casually and returns to his book. The marking on the door was painted recently, judging from its pungent scent. You recognize the symbol immediately for what it is, a warning of death fog within. You press your palm against the door to open it. The wood feels neither cold nor warm, but simply gray. The crimson drains from your hand, and you are left numb. It doesn't budge. The door groans open, but an ashen shadow clouds your mind.
I need to get out of here, now!
Ancients. I need to get off this ship.
Oh, no!
So much for a peaceful stroll. lifeboat! That means there's still a chance!
Children and dwarfs first, just like the old stories say.
The dwarf yanks at one of the nearby ropes to no avail.
You said there were other people down there. We need to help them.
You see those tentacles, kid? It's time for getting the hell out of here.
The Magister lies on the floor.
If you could walk, get yourself off the ladder. There's a boat. Wait! Voidwalker!
Beardless bugs won't sink the ship on my watch.
I thought Voidwoken was supposed to be scary.
Let the games begin.
I've faced worse.
Telling where there might be more. We need to move.
Away. The sea's hungry. We don't...
Bishop Alexander, the smug little tyke that thinks he can imprison a prince. How come?
Just leave me be.
Get on with you.
Honorable Dallas, we lost a ship sailing sorcerer prisoners to Fort Joy. We assume some escaped and broke their collars. Their vile magic lured the Voidwoken. All who were aboard are presumed dead. Yours faithfully into eternity, High Judge Orivan.
Well, that was a bit of a rough-and-tumble journey. I suppose I'm the lone survivor. Which is entirely appropriate, if you ask me.